Very good morning to everyone here. Good morning, ma'am. As you know, today's theme is Divinity. So I thought it will be a good theme because we all do yoga early morning. Actually, I don't know the actual meaning of the Divinity, but it's somewhat related to meditation and to know ourselves better. Okay. Today's intern lecture speaker is Kasturi Shah. I will introduce her. Kasturi Shah hails from Kalaburgi, Karnataka. She is currently pursuing her Bachelor in Information Technology and Management studies at Symbiosis Institution, Pune. Kasturi is extremely passionate about giving back to the society and helping the needy. In her free time, Kasturi volunteers to enable education for children in underprivileged areas. In addition to this, she has also worked with several NGOs on several projects for upliftment of social capital. An art and culture enthusiast, Kasturi plays the guitar and enjoys dancing. Her achievements are as follows: recipient of Rajya Puraskar Award from Governor of Karnataka for Scouts and Guides, awarded for Senior Service to Mankind, winner of several prizes in national level Bharatanatyam dance competition, district level chess player under 19, and a Red Cross member. So I would like to give the dice to the Kasturi to begin the program. Thank
you. Good morning, everyone. How are you all? Fit and fine after yesterday's dinner? No one is sick, right? Okay. So today I'm going to speak on Sudha Murthy. It's not only about her, it's also about what she writes. She's an author. Let's start with a quote today. When a doctor makes a mistake, a person goes 6 feet below the ground. When a doctor makes a mistake, a person goes 6 feet below the ground. When a judge makes a mistake, a person is hung 6 feet above the ground. When a judge makes a mistake, a person is hung 6 feet above the ground. But when a teacher makes a mistake, the entire batch of students is destroyed. But when a teacher makes a mistake, the entire batch of students is destroyed. Don't ever look down on teachers. Here, teachers are not only ones who physically present, it's also about all the experiences we learn. We tend to ignore many small stories which happen on day-to-day basis in our lives. But trust me, guys, more than teachers, they also help us. They also turn us from within. Who is Sudha Murthy? She's a teacher. First, she loves profession called teaching. But she not only teaches through her words or through her subject, she also teaches us through writing stories, which are given lots and lots of experiences. So that might help us. She's an Indian author. She writes different children's stories, non-fiction stories. She writes for different magazines. She's the chairperson of Infosys Foundation. Infosys, I guess most of you have heard about it. It's a software company. And today, its net valuation is $100 billion, which is more than 70 lakh crores. And this is an Indian company, which is started by her and her husband. And at the same time, Infosys started with 10,000 rupees. And today, it is here. She's graduated from BVB Engineering College. I'll tell you an interesting story. There are 1,500 children in the college, and she was the only girl. There were no girls' toilet. There were she used to get humiliated. These boys used to throw ink on her. They used to rag her. But she, in the course of four years, she never, not even a single time, she thought that she should drop out from the college and not continue doing engineering. She's the first female engineer. She worked in telco. There was a case when JRD Tata had put a recruitment advertisement in the newspaper, wherein it was written, females must not apply. So this went on to her mind. She wrote a letter to JRD Tata, and with all the different interviews, she cleared along with men, and she was placed at one of the top institutions, one of the top positions in her company. She is married to Narayan Murthy. Narayan Murthy is CEO of Infosys. And she has also got awards like R.K. Narayan Award for Literature and Padma Shri in 2006. She's written many books like Mahashweta or Vice and Otherwise and The Mother I Never Knew. I just don't want to tell about author today. I want to tell about the experiences she wrote in a book. That might somewhere help us, because these are what teach us, these are what make us. Today I'm here because of my experiences. I still don't remember what teachers taught me about life when I was in fourth or fifth standard. Today I'm here because what all my experiences taught me, what all my friends' experiences taught me, what all my parents' experience taught me, what all my teachers' experiences taught me. So this is a book which she wrote, Wise and Otherwise, A Salute to a Life. It's a non-fiction book. Now let's get few insights of this book. Honesty comes from heart. This is the first chapter of a book. So I'll tell you the story. Once she saw there was news that a very poor boy scored topped in an exam, in a 12th or maybe 10th exam. She saw it, she tried contacting the guy. She called him to Bangalore. He traveled all the way from his village to Bangalore. When he came to the village, she asked him that we are ready to fund you. Will you study in whichever top college you want in Bangalore? We'll look after your stay, we'll look after your studies. You know, that guy answered very sincerely, "Ma'am, I don't want to study in a city. I'm okay with studying in a district which is nearby my village. I can look after my family. I can also study well and I can focus on my studies very well." Ma'am was like, "Okay, sure, why not? Then we'll look after the funding." She used to send 300 rupees, had a lot of value then. She used to send 300 rupees every month. One month what happened was, she forgot because of festivals or ups and downs in the company or maybe busy in her work, she forgot to send the money. And she was late in sending her money. She sent the money in a wallet. After 2 days, that wallet came back mentioning there was a note written on it. "Ma'am, I'm really sorry I'm sending you back the money because from 2 months I had not gone to college because we had festivals and there was a fest in my college and we had holidays for a month. This is what honesty means." You know, when someone is being honest to you, it's not about telling someone, "Yeah, I'm honest with you." It's about acting. It's about being and telling, "Yeah, I'm honest with you." She's doing so much for him. There's someone else who would be in his place would be like, "Okay, fine, I'll use this money further." Maybe he'll convince himself telling, "No, next time I'll buy books. It'll be useful." It'll be someone convincing, I'm not telling that they'll use it for bad things, but at least they'll be convincing ourselves, telling, "No, I'll use it for good things and it won't cause any harm." So this is what makes a difference, and this is where she being the wife of Narayan Murthy, she still thinks of those small instances that touch the heart. A lesson in humility. So there's a village in Sayadri Mountains. She's gone. She visited that mountains. There was a school, small school, wherein there was a guard. The one who looks after school. He didn't have clothes. He didn't have proper clothes. The condition of this was very bad. First visit, she looked after the problems. When she went on to her second visit, that guard he gifted her a shawl and bottle. She had taken some clothes, some books with her, and had done something for school. That the guard who didn't even have 2 times proper food intended to give her this shawl and a gift of gratitude. There are several charitable organizations wherein people serve them, but still they give complaints. In fact, we are getting so much, we still find loopholes. "No, I didn't get that." Guys, come on, you're getting it for free. You're getting it with someone's getting it from someone's heart, but still we complain. But what does this person has? He has nothing, but he's still. And he is not even educated. Come on, he teaches us such a big lesson of life. Okay, so when the mob count didn't tally. So this is a chapter which you have to read. Okay, I won't tell the story, but it's really very nice. Okay, so now this is all about what she wrote. Now I'll tell you my life experience, my story. Then I want you all to share one of your stories, any few among them. Okay, let's start. So a 7-year kid taught me what friendship is. Not 7 years, 7th standard, okay? So we used to conduct Bal Dhamal, which is a sports games, wherein that day, what happened? They had a race. one was standing at this corner, one guy. He didn't have slippers. And the floor, because we are not conducting on some stadium or something, we didn't have that much funding or something where we conduct races. But it was just a normal ground. That day, he was not able to run, maybe because of two to three days before. He had got some, something on his leg. Injury, yeah. One guy from there came running and he was like, you wear my chappals. But they are so poor that they don't even have chappals to wear them. I asked, are you on the same race? You're running with him? He's like, yes. Like, will you be able to run? He's like, yes, I'll be able to run. And the guy said, why do you want to help him? I asked him. He's like, he got hurt. First thing what happened was, he was like, he got hurt and I don't want him to run bare feet. These two people are running in the same race. They are running, they're competing with each other. But still, he's helping. I asked him, why do you want to do this? They call me Didi. He said, Didi, because he's my friend. And that one line touched my heart. Because even doing this, because when we are competing with each other, we don't even bother if it's getting hurt, if that other person what we are talking is getting hurt by our words. So these are simple things. One more I would like to share is determination. I have a friend, very good friend of mine. He's from a village. He is doing his engineering, he's in fourth year of engineering. And at the same time, he's studying UPSC with me, he's in my class. Guys, I'll tell you, he's not in a condition to pay his fees. He pays in installments. But till 4 o'clock he has college, he makes sure 8 o'clock till 8 o'clock, whatever his daytime, he makes sure he does everything. At night, 10 o'clock, he works under an ATM as a guard and studies all night there. Next day, he comes to the class with that enthusiasm. He comes, he answers in the class, he makes sure he involves with everyone around. So that is the determination. He doesn't have anything. Today, we all are sitting here because we are able to manage our finances, which means that we are pretty good in our economical backgrounds, right? So still, instead of that, we procrastinate sometimes. We don't prioritize our family or we don't prioritize our education or the dreams which we have. So someone like that who has nothing, he can take a degree, go back to his village, be there, no one will even bother him. His parents don't even know what he's doing here. But still, he makes sure he earns at the same time. It's not a joke studying all night or sitting under an ATM and making a guard when all his friends are sleeping at night in their houses. And it's not easy to mingle up with the same, with the different kind of people around you who have different backgrounds, who are rich, who are poor, who are middle class people. It's not that easy. So it requires guts. So this is an experience. I'll be like, every time when I get demotivated, I'll be like, look, he's studying there. He doesn't have anything. Now here in AC, can't I study for 2 minutes or can't I study for 2 hours? So this is what taught me. So guys, anyone of you would like to share? So anyone among us? Come on, you're 20 or you're more than 20. Life didn't teach you anything? Yes, sir. Sir might have a meeting.
Good morning, all. So it's again about friendship. So when we tell about friendship, we talk about friendship, like most of us, we feel like, okay, we'll hang out together, we'll go, okay, if my friend bunked the class, okay, I'll also bunk with him. If he copies in the exam, okay, I'll help him, okay, all these things happens, okay, that's the other part of the friendship. See, please understand, okay, even there's other side of the friendship, okay, see, me and my best friend, close friend, the best, okay, so we are like railway tracks, something which he like, I don't like, which I like, he don't like. Okay, you want to practice architecture, I want to teach architecture. But we are the best friends. Even if you go now to my college until 2016 batch, you can hear only two names, Karthik, Vijay. See, it's a friendship like where we just parallelly helped each other to grow wherever, whatever the interest. So that is the friendship. Please have that kind of friendship more. Thank you.
Good morning, guys. I just want to share a small story which I had experienced. And everyone, you must be knowing, I was an NCC cadet. So when I was going for the RD parade and all, I had to attend several camps in all rural areas. And people from all the backgrounds used to come, people from deemed universities. And there were cadets who were from very, humble background, very poor background, the economic condition of them is so low that they can't even afford shoes. So I had to stay with those people. So first when I went there, people didn't accept me because they were like, you're something different, you can't be with me. So I was like, there's no problem, I'll be with you guys. So initial days when I was there, they didn't accept me as a friend. They used to think I'm somewhat big. I was like, there's nothing like that, I'm the same. So when I was spending time with them, they had to select only a few people, nearly about 600 in number. They had to select about 80 people. So they made our life very miserable so that we drop out ourselves. So most of them were so determined, so they didn't do. So they made us to do what all the shit, they wantedly made us to do everything. And at that point of time, there was a time when, guys, you know the ration rice, that's a big one. So I never had in my life, never ever. So I went there, I saw it, and I didn't eat the food for the first 3-4 days. And I used to watch these people, you know, for them coming to the camp and eating food used to be like a feast. Because for them, the families are so poor, if they work on a daily basis, then only the stomach will get filled. So when they come here, they get breakfast, they get dinner, they get lunch, they get all the three. So they don't mind what they get. They are happy for the reason that they're able to eat something. So people like us, we hate it. What is this? I never ate. Gee. But for them, it's a feast. They used to love and eat. I saw it for like 4-5 days. I lost my weight like 3-4 kgs. I didn't eat anything. I used to only have bread. Then I realized, okay, this is life. So that's the point. I was like, there are a lot of people who are still there. Because guys, we must have seen Kasturi told most of us, I believe we are from a, okay, at like good background or a middle class family, but there are people who cannot even afford to have lunch. So if the parents work on a daily basis, they get food. If not, they won't. They stay, you know, they will be hungry for the whole day. So when I was there with them, I learned a lot of things. And then they started accepting when I started eating the same food. I ate the same food. I used to stay with them. I used to sleep with them. So that's how is the humanity, guys. Like, it is not there, you know, in pictures, good, Sadhguru, whatever. It is there within us. So that is what I want to tell. See, if you, you know, do something, show off, it doesn't mean anything. Such type of gestures is more than enough for them. So from that day, they started accepting me as a friend. And because of them, I can proudly tell you, whatever Tamil I've learnt, it's because of those guys. They taught me Tamil. My college, never. It used to be English and Hindi. And outside also, I used to only speak in Hindi. Only because those guys, I learned Tamil. And I was very proud one day, because I spent with them nearly about 4 months. And there was a guy who used to come every single day to me, just to learn English. And I used to teach one, two words every day. And at the end of third month, one day he straight away came on the stage. He spoke in English. Everyone clapped. And I was sitting at the corner. When everyone went, he came to me. He hugged me. He said, thank you. I felt so happy for that. So that's what our humanity lies nowhere. It lies within us.
Okay, this is also a short one. Okay, it's not about friendship and all that, but it's like a miracle. I went to watch a movie with my family. After the movie got over, everyone's gate from one door, right? The way there is so much crowd. So there was one man in front of me, his wallet fallen down. Okay. So I saw that thing, it's fallen down, so I speak up. And he was went away from the family. Then I ran away. I thought he should not go here and there, so I just ran away, and I was just checking the parking where he is. So he was at the corner, so I went there and I gave him the wallet. I didn't see the wallet also. I given the wallet. Okay, he said me thank you and all that. On the next day, when I was going traveling with my bike outside, my mother told me to bring something from the shop. So I went there. And while coming, I purchased some few household things like that, something food. So my wallet was in my, I was wearing a track pant. So my wallet was in that thing. So it fell under. I was not knowing. I came home, take bath. I was reading something. I watched TV.
At the evening, my father got a call that we have a wallet of your son. My father is a policeman. He was in traffic police also for some more years. So from the traffic office, my father got a call. And my father came towards me and he asked me, Sahil, where is your wallet? I said, it will be here or it will be in the table or in my wallet. I just went and searched. It was not there. So the story is, I lost my wallet on the road. It fell down on my packet. Someone took that wallet, they bring it to the traffic police. And on that was on the next day. And the traffic police called my father because he knows my father and all that. And I got the wallet the next day. So it was like I have given and I am returning back on the next day. Every time we don't get at the next day only, next time it takes time. But on the next day only I got the thing which I have written. So it was I feel very good.
This is a story about my friend. There's this one guy who used to study with us.
So everyone shared experience about external world. I was expecting someone would share an experience with internal world. Internal world is our family. It's our parents. Wanna?
She said family. So the best thing I can speak about is my dad. His mother passed away when he was in 10th and his father suffered a stroke at that point of time. He took care of his father from feeding to cleaning him for 2 years. And at around 12th, his father passes away. Once this happens, my dad had nowhere to live because I don't want to speak about his brothers. He was basically all by himself. Our family profession, we are called Darjis, Marathis, is tailoring. He started tailoring. He did various jobs. Like your friend, he used to walk for about 8 to 9 kilometers from his home to his school, come back, work. And he tried various jobs. He didn't get selected anywhere. He tried All India Radio, Indian Railways, 1,000 different things. He got in nowhere. Then he decided to study. He studied well. And then he cleared KAS, Karnataka Administrative Service. He's a civil servant now. He's a district level officer. All this, whatever I have today, whatever my brother has today, whatever my mother has today, everything because of my dad. And he built himself from ground zero. The next story I want to share about is about my friend. He's from Tamil Nadu, actually, at Amra. His father was supposed to be a cook. He cooked for 3 months in a temple and then he started drinking. He drank way too much. People never knew, his family never knew. One day they randomly go to Bangalore to visit him. Even his father knew that they're going to visit him, but his father was nowhere to be found. Then they found out that he drinks a lot. Then he brings back his father. Then they had no source of income whatsoever. They're still doing, struggling with life. Then he joined for BCom in Bangalore, Seshadripuram College, in the morning college. We all love college, don't we? Go, have fun, come back. He dropped out of morning college. He joined the evening college. He started working he did BCom, so he was working under some CA first for about 4,000 rupees per month. That was the entire source of income for him, his brother, his mother, and his father. And then he got into some data entry firm, and he started making about 10,000 a month. He travels about 35 to 40 kilometers in BMTC within Bangalore traffic on a daily basis. And he still does that. He finished his BCom. He's trying for civil defense service or CDS exams. I don't know the full form. He is also very mad about army. I hope he joins army soon. He deserves it. His brother is still doing engineering, actually. It's actually the other way around. His brother is studying at home with his mother. He is in Bangalore working and earning for the family. These are the two stories I wanted to share.
So we all have different experiences, right? So I would just like to suggest sometimes remember those. Those make you strong. Those make you what you are. Ending to his thing is, guys, family is everything. Today you all are here, it's because of family. So respect it, respect others, And I would like to end my talk with just one thing, telling when a child enters a room, don't look at the child as you're a teacher. Look at a child as you're a student. You never know what all it'll teach you. Thank you.